that undoubtedly there has been in recent time, it really is a very big thank you. We're pretty confident, we know it will have been worth it, because having this additional connectivity, which you will have when it goes into service on Monday, will be very quick to yield very visible and significant benefits. So a very, very big thank you to the people of Withenshaw. We're holding an event on Saturday to allow people to ride the system, to see what it's like, and I hope they'll agree with me that the actual job itself, the quality of the ride that you experience, is second to none. It is a fantastic ride that's been created from Chorlton through to Withenshaw and Manchester Airport.
It's not only just the benefits to people that live and work in Withenshaw, it's a benefit to the whole of Greater Manchester. Perhaps you tell me a bit about that.
Well, it does, and of course that's a reflection of it being funded by people of Greater Manchester. There's no specific government funding into this. It's Greater Manchester council leaders and politicians and funding from Greater Manchester council taxpayers in the main that are funding this, and the benefits will be very widespread. But yes, Withenshaw people will be the principal beneficiaries in giving them access, easier access to the hospital, to the town centre and the airport, but also giving them access to the jobs at the airport and the new jobs that will be created at Airport City. Of course, people applying for those new jobs won't just be local, they will be coming from further afield, and this airport Metrolink extension will make it easier for people to get access to those jobs, but also enable people from Withenshaw to access jobs elsewhere in the city centre, in Trafford Park, when we get the line there built in hopefully a few years' time, and beyond, giving the interchanges that it does give with the rail network in other parts of Greater Manchester. So huge benefits all around. The town centre interchange, which is locating the bus station and other facilities right next to the tram stop, is well underway, so we're hoping that will be completed and put into service next summer, so it will all come together very, very well indeed. The only other side of the story is that because we're opening this early, we're only able to run the service as far as Cornbrook, because we don't have the capacity across Manchester city centre to run these additional trams to their ultimate destination, which is scheduled to be Manchester Victoria. So we're currently building the second city crossing. You have seen the start of that work in the city centre. Again, very disruptive, but very necessary to get this additional capacity. And when that is finished, hopefully at the beginning of 2017, we'll then be able to run these additional services from at the airport in Withenshaw through to Victoria, where people will be able to change onto the other Metrolink services and the railway services.
Hi, I'm Ken Stansfield, and you're listening to the Unedited Audio Experience with Sandra Shufflebottom. Enjoy.
I realize that I've been, in your eyes, some kind of fool. What I do, what I did, stupid fish, I drank the pool. I've been doing some dying, now I'm doing some trying. So say, don't mind, and let me off this time. I came into this scene when my dreams were getting bad. And who rides with the tide and who's glad with what it had? I've been doing some whining, now I'm doing some finding. So say, don't mind, you let me off this time. Thank you.
so bad that a doormat sees better times. That's a time to get back and think up some better line. I've been doing some growing, but I'm scared for you going. So say you don't mind, you don't mind, you let me off this time.
Hi, this is Oz from The Reality Party, and you're listening to the Unedited Audio Experience with Sandra Shufflebottom. Enjoy.
Hey, hey, hey. I'm trying to stop this. Stop. No. Stop. Stop. Right, it's finished now. Right. Now you can start. I really must get him to go through this with me. They keep running, these CD players, they keep running, and I don't like it, you see. Right, so you're with me, and I didn't play that, did I? I meant to play this, to just so he'd let you know who I am. And it's one. No. Oh, no, I didn't play it, did I? Ah, this is what I meant to play. No, go on, go on.
Hi, I'm Kane Stansfield, yeah. And you're listening to the Unedited Audio Experience with Sandra Shufflebottom. Enjoy.
Ah, see, so you know who I am now, don't you? Right, so, for the next few minutes, because it is weird, well weird, looking at 8 o'clock for the past hour. Alan Law, right, he's this bloke in Minneapolis. And, he goes out every night, every single night. And they call him Sandwich Man. And he just makes sandwiches for loads of people. You dare start your checks. For everyone. And he doesn't come back till 12 o'clock the next day. He's just out giving out sandwiches. Don't get paid for it, nothing. Brilliant. There's a bloke called, who's dead now, Boyd Bushman, and he's just been all over Facebook, well, my Facebook anyway, the past couple of weeks. His mate had he has got loads of stuff, but he's dead now, but he did like a deathbed confession thing. His mate had a grey E.T. And when this grey E.T. died, a photo showed that the E.T. in spirit was it next to his mate. So instead they stay around for 3 days like humans. So that means that they have a soul. So all this soul-capturing nonsense that some people go around the country talking, absolute rubbish. And you make money out of it. Good on you. Good on you if you do. But there's no all this soul-capturing nonsense. Let me just call it nonsense. I could use loads of other words, but I'll just keep calling it nonsense. It's nonsense. Ugh. You won't believe how many people are out there talking about it. This Boyd Bushman said Area 51 is working with China and Russia trying to make UFOs, reverse engineering. Loads of scientists have died. And he will be sent pieces. Oh, can I check? Pieces of UFOs, anti-gravity with crystals. He's got some great shots of feet. ET's feet. So he's got three ribs, and they're about 5 foot. It was really, really, really brilliant. That you must watch that. Boyd, you just Google Boyd Bushman, you'll find it. A huge Liberian diamond find. Months before the Ebola outbreak. Isn't that weird? Isn't that weird that that should happen? But the Queen's speech has been leaked, and she says fracking is, you know, cool. Anywhere, don't matter. You can have it, yeah. It's cool with her. And the average person walks past a murderer 36 times in their life. And I was thinking, how on earth can you work that out? And it's a fun fact, because it didn't kill you, which I thought, it just made me laugh. Right, George, Galway. Galloway. George knows Galway, innit? Anyway, he said Russell Brand must be doing something right, seeing he's upsetting so many. of the elites. Russell can back his mouth up with his facts, and probably why they're so upset. I really must read his book, that revolution. More people now believe in aliens than God, according to a poll in The Guardian. And a space agency attempts to steal evidence of ET life, claimed a Sri Lankan politician. I remember now, and his name was that long, and I just couldn't get my tongue around it, but his first name was Wimai W, right? It began with a W, his surname. So, W-I-M-A-I, Wimai, says, white men try to steal the fragments of a meteor that was well weird. It had, you know, things on it that couldn't be, they're not human. It disproves creationism, you know what I mean?
I believe God created me in 7 days. I think he rushed it.
Right, and what I'm going to do now, it's so weird without, what time is it? 56. I bet, you know what, I better not play. I'll play a bit of a one. Let me see. No, I like that wall paint. I like that one. I've not heard it for ages anyway. So, yeah, I've got to go now. With having no clock in here, it's like, well, weird. And I can't judge the time or anything, so I'm best if I just get off now. So, come back next week and feed yourself.